Hello and welcome to Opted Monster. If you're comfortable working with HTML, CSS, and possibly even some JavaScript, we make it easy to connect with a custom HTML form. This option is perfect if you're looking to add extra fields to your opt-in form or use an email service provider we don't natively integrate with. In this video, I'll show you how to connect Opted Monster with a custom HTML form. But first, if you haven't done so already, be sure to hit that subscribe button and notification bell. Now, let's get started. So I've just finished designing my campaign, and now I'm ready to connect my custom HTML form. Since I've started from one of Opted Monster's built-in templates, I already have an opt-in block added to my campaign. However, if you started from the Canvas template, you'll need to ensure that you've added an opt-in block in the location you want your form to appear. Now you can disregard what you see here currently, as this will be replaced with our custom HTML form when we add it. This existing opt-in block is merely acting as a placeholder at the moment. To add the custom HTML form, I'll head over to Integrations. Next, I'll select Add New Integration, and then select Custom HTML from the menu. Then, I can simply paste my custom form code into the HTML editor. In order to track conversions with this custom form, I'll need to add the class om-trigger-conversion to the Submit button. This will record a conversion in Opted Monster, and also set any cookies I specified when building my campaign. To track conversions without setting cookies, use the class om-trigger-alt-conversion instead. Alright, my form is now appearing in the campaign, but it could use a little styling to make it look a little nicer. So I'll head back over to the Design tab and navigate to Settings. And then, in the Advanced tab, under Custom CSS, I can add some styling to my form. Likewise, if I wanted to add some validation checks to the form fields, I could do so by adding my JavaScript here in the Custom JavaScript section. Alright, this looks much better. Now, all that's left to do is set my display rules, and then save and publish the campaign. If you have any questions, browse through our helpful documentation. Or, for further assistance, you could submit a support ticket, and we'd be happy to help.